Hi everyone, in this step-by-step tutorial, you will learn how to protect your data on external USB drives so that you won't have any regrets if they get lost or stolen. During this process, I will use disk utility on a MacBook Pro M1 running macOS Ventura 13.5. Let's begin. First, let me move my little friend out of the way. Connect your USB flash drive or SSD to an available USB port on your Mac. After a few seconds, you should see its icon on your desktop. Here is a helpful tip. If you can see your device icon on your desktop, click the Finder icon in the dock or anywhere on your desktop. Next, go to Finder and select Settings. Click on the General tab and make sure the External Disks option is selected. Before proceeding, backup any important data on your USB or SSD. Therefore, I will copy this folder to the desktop. Next, press Command plus space to open the Spotlight search. Then type disk utility in the search box and press Enter on your keyboard. Once disk utility is launched, go to View and select Show all devices from the drop-down menu. You will see a list of all connected drives on the left-hand side. Locate and select your external USB flash or SSD from this list, and ensure you choose the correct one to avoid any accidental data loss. Your external drive is the first one listed under external. This is your internal drive, and this one is the external. We want to format the external USB. Click on the first icon at the top. With the device selected, click the Erase button in the toolbar at the top of the disk utility window. In the Erase dialog box, give your device a name, for example, Work. To optimize the copying of files and reduce the likelihood of corrupted files, I will choose the APFS option for formatting. This format is suitable for SSDs and flash drives. As for the scheme option, I will select the GUID partition map. In my case, I plan to use my USB flash drive with my MacBook Pro M1 running the Ventura 13.5 operating system. I have no plans to use my USB with an older Mac or operating system, and I don't intend to connect it to a Windows PC. Therefore, APFS is the ideal format for me. Additionally, since I want to secure my USB with a password, I will choose APFS encrypted. APFS stands for Apple File System. If you own an older Mac running an operating system version prior to High Sierra macOS 10.13, you may not be able to use the APFS format. In such cases, you can choose macOS Extended Journal or macOS Extended Journal Encrypted to format your external USB or SSD. This format is compatible with older Mac systems. This will enable you to use your external storage device with your older Mac. Now you need to set a password, but before that, write it down on a piece of paper so that you won't forget it when you need to enter it for the second time. After entering your password, you can enter an optional password hint. For example, I love strawberries. You can enter whatever you like, but ensure it is not too obvious. Then click Choose. Finally, click the Erase button to begin the process. This will completely erase the contents of the external drive and encrypt it with the password you provided. The process of erasing is complete. From now on, whenever you plug the USB drive into your Mac, it will prompt you for the password before allowing access to its contents. To ensure everything works as expected, right-click on your drive, eject it, and reconnect it to your Mac. After reconnecting, enter your password, click on Lock, copy your files and folders, remove it and connect it again to verify there are no problems. By the way, if you would like to have a cute dog or cat on your desktop, click on the tutorial thumbnail at the end of this video. The app is completely free and I'm sure you will enjoy their company. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.